Well, it's finally here. We are in the Diamond DA50 RG with Lifestyle Aviation, and today we are bringing you the first ever virtual Diamond DA50 demo flight.
Imagine passing a check ride being completely hands-off. We're full back on the stick, and this is all she does. That's it.
Wow. We're coming down at about 2,500 feet a minute.
So you cannot do this in any other air-cooled engine because all you're going to do is shock-cool the motor. Good morning, guys. We're up here at Centennial. The field elevation here is about 5,800 feet. We're going to take off out of here, go down to the south, probably circle around, like, you know, get close to Pike's Peak and other things like that down to the south and have some fun today. But when we get up to altitude, I'll let Patrick be somebody who's checking out the airplane. He's going to go up. We're going to do slow flight, steep turns, and stalls, showcase some of the airwork of this particular airplane. And then while we do that, we'll feature some stuff with the G1000 NXI avionics as well.
So we're already up and running, but I want to go ahead and have Sam run us through a typical startup in the DA50.
DA50, it's a six-cylinder twin turbocharged engine. Burns Jet A. Treat it like a diesel engine because it's got, of course, glow plugs on it. Startup is really simple. We get our electric master on first, and then we wait for all the systems to come up. We wait for this little page to appear that's basically telling us that G1000 is ready for startup. Then we grab our engine master switch, put it in the on position. You'll see the glow plug light come on. Whenever it comes on, it means that the glow plugs are, of course, burning in the cylinders to warm everything up for ease of start. Once those go out, hold down that engine start button for about 5 to 10 seconds. It's a little longer in the DA50 than we're used to in the other jet A burning pistons of the Astros. Hold it down until you see about 400 to 500 RPM on the prop, and that means the engine started.
Sweet. Yeah. That's a great explanation.
So the run-up in this thing is very similar to what we would see in other jet A burning pistons that we've been used to in Diamonds. Come back to idle. Go ahead and hold down that ECU test button. It's going to fail both ECUs. We see a little bit of RPM changes.
Yep.
There goes down one.
Yep, and it's just cycling the prop on its own. It's failing ECU A this time.
You got it.
Testing both of them, make sure they're good to go.
Now it comes back up. You
and
can
we
let
have
go.
Zero errors.
Zero errors. Very, very simple run-up procedure.
That was seamless and easy.
You know, it's amazing to me how many people get in these airplanes. And, you know, I've been so used to it because I've got so many hours in jet A burning pistons. But just the idea that you don't have to talk to your engine or anything like that. You just have a computer that's managing everything and ensuring that it's in optimum condition for what you're about to do that day.
That's right. Even starting up an engine, there's no priming. There's no throwing the mixture in right when you turn the key or anything like that.
It's just very simple and basic.
Good morning, ground 150 Romeo Golf, information Sierra at Jet Center. We're at Diamond DA50 VFR to the south.
Diamond Zero Romeo Golf from a 3-5 right, taxi alpha, and just make sure you're squawking 1200, squawking VFR.
Squawking VFR, and we'll taxi to 3-5 right via alpha, 150 Romeo Golf.
All right, guys, so to give you the best virtual demo flight possible, we have five cameras rolling currently right now. We got one facing us, one facing this panel right here, so you can see everything we're doing, including our airspeed and altitude. We got one facing the right side of on the right wing. We got one showing the gear and what's in front of us. And then, of course, we have one behind us as just for that extra views. We hope you guys enjoy that. We work hard to give you that best experience possible. All right, so let's talk about takeoff procedure.
Yeah.
So we're going to pull onto the runway. We're going to get lined up. And then this is our throttle here. So we're, what is it, a three-second push?
So I always tell our guys 3 seconds on the throttle quadrant. Our rotate speed is 66. Our VY is 79. So I always tell people, you don't rotate immediately at 66. Right around 70 is fine. Mm-hmm. Fly right off the runway. If anything happens while we're on the runway, we just pull the power back.
And land it right back on the
right
runway.
Land it right down on the runway.
Number 150 Romeo Golf, Centennial Tower, wind 340 at 7, fly straight out, runway 35 right, clear for takeoff.
35 right, clear for takeoff, straight out, 150 Romeo Golf.
Cool.
All right, let's do
so,
it.
So, clear for takeoff, confirm 35 right, fuel pumps on, lights on,
yep.
Takeoff flaps engaged.
Final is clear.
Yep.
Let's get right on the center line.
So right. Get her lined up going straight and then start that 3 seconds on the power.
Now let's do it.
A little bit of left right.
Heels on the floor. 1, 2, 3. 92% power. RPM's looking good. Everything's in the green.
Yep.
We're at 50. just passing the 1,000 footers.
Yep. We got soon to be 60. There's 60. She's ready to fly, but hold her down for just half a second longer and pull her back a little bit more. There we go. There's that stall warning horn. We'll get that off. There we go.
Right there. Perfect.
We have a positive rate of climb.
All right.
Here's coming up.
Project 307, wind 3507, fly spread out, runway 3 foot right, clear for takeoff.
Fly straight out, 3 foot right, clear for takeoff. Clear track 307.
And pitch me over just a little. Yep, this is perfect. I'll dump the flaps, keep her at 85.
All right, 85. Look at that, we're climbing at 800 feet per minute.
Number 0 Romeo Golf, proceed on course.
On course, thank you, to the southwest, 150 Romeo Golf.
Left turn. We'll do a turn over to west.
Left traffic change 2, runway 35 left.
We'll stay right below these clouds here.
There we go, nice.
If it's okay with you, I'm going to bring the power back to about 92.
Yeah, we got 5 minutes of this takeoff power, and then 90% is max continuous.
90%.
So we just got out of Denver. We're there's no Class Bravo shelf above us anymore. A couple things we'll showcase is right now we're in a bit of a high-speed test. So we're at 9,500 feet. It's 54 degrees Fahrenheit out here. Went ahead and closed the cowl flaps.
Yeah, look at that, 174.
173, yep. So it's gonna hover right around here. Keep in mind with all things, this is at a max power setting, so you can consistently run this all day long. We're burning 15 gallons an hour, so 3 hours of this would be 45 gallons. So 2.5 hours to 3 hours is a very safe estimate. Very respectable speed for this kind of platform. And, you know, super stable type aircraft for sure.
All right, so we're right at 12 gallons an hour.
We stabilized.
We're stabilized, and we're showing 160 knots true.
Yeah.
So 3.5 hours, 30 minutes reserve at 160 true.
Not bad at all.
Not
and
bad.
We're well loaded down on everything. Beautiful mountainous terrain that we're flying over today. What we'll do is we'll circle around here and go to low area and do some air work. I'll just give us on a heading bug. This is, of course, the GFC 700 autopilot. The thing I love about this is it'll let me pick where I want to be. And then in mountainous terrain, I can turn over this terrain map and just pick my way through it to where I know I'm going to be safe and clear of all obstacles. That thing straight ahead right there is that mountain.
Right.
It shows up right there.
We're just too high, so we're just going to deviate.
Yep,
to
so
the
we're
right.
Just going to deviate a little bit around and, you know, have some fun today for sure.
Yeah, that sounds great. Man, this is absolutely beautiful out here.
That's gorgeous.
Absolutely gorgeous.
So we're just going to kind of do air work maneuvering around here. So, Patrick, this is a great opportunity for you to turn off the autopilot and start to get a feel for the airplane.
Sure.
So go ahead and hit that red button.
All right.
And we'll do it kind of in this lower area.
Sure.
A little bit.
We'll feel these push rods right here.
Yep.
We'll cut back this way and see what this thing's got.
So with all diamonds, there's direct link push rods throughout the wings, so everything is very well balanced.
I mean, we're in a steep turn right now, and it's not a difficult thing to do at all.
No, it really isn't, just because of how well balanced this airplane is and how they rig the whole system. You know, there's no slop in it, so I always love doing this and showing people, you know, it's just dead on. We're going to disable ESP for a minute. Electronic stability protection is an envelope protection system that Garmin has to where if we roll past a certain point, it's going to fight us and they'll push against us.
Sure.
So we're going to roll into a commercial steep turn right about here.
Yep.
And then I'm going to take a few seconds to rig up this track vector, and then we are completely hands off in
Look
everything we're doing right now.
And it's holding altitude. We have our 45 degree steep turn.
And I'll nudge it every now and again and give it a little bit of love right here. But imagine passing a check ride being basically completely hands-off.
That's cheating, Sam.
100% cheating.
That's
I mean,
cheating.
It's a testament to the airplane.
It really
and
is.
Its capabilities. Now, you know, people say, oh, well, you got to retrim it when you go back the other direction. Well, watch this. We're going to grab the stick. I'm not even going to touch the trim. We're going to roll her back the opposite direction, right at the same spot. And 3, 2, 1, hands-off. I even did it in 2 seconds.
Wow.
So this is hands
off. Holding right there.
Holding dead on. Now I can make a little correction just to where we can be dead on with everything, but pretty amazing.
But still, what other airplane can you do that in?
You really can't. I mean, there's other than the other diamonds, you can definitely lock them on and maximize them, but this just is a testament to the capabilities of this
right.
particular airplane and the stability with it. I'm going to go ahead and climb us up, start a climb up to about 10,500 feet. I don't have to worry one bit about the engine. You know, in other air-cooled airplanes, I'd be leaning them out a little bit more. I'd be trying to redo my EGTs, CHTs. This one, I just set it for the percentage of power I want to get, and Fedic does everything for me. High altitude, 10,800 feet. We're going to be doing slow flight.
So let's go ahead and get on this heading of, we'll do 300.
Sounds good.
And then I'm just going to start walking the power back.
So we're going to do gear down, flaps down. So the idea is this is minimum controllable airspeed and show you how much aileron control you still have. Our limitation on the gear is 162 indicated, but what you'll find is it's really, really hard to overspeed that.
Right.
So the gear basically is a gigantic speed break. Yeah, under our flap speed, 133. Pitch up really quick and you'll hear the stall warning horn right there.
All right, yep.
So there it is right there. We're going to add a bit of power to catch for that.
All right.
We're going to maintain our altitude. And I just want you to slowly maneuver the wings around, feel what it feels like in a turn. If you feel the horn, add a bit of power.
Sure,
and
yep.
Pitch her down.
Right about there, yep. We're just doing a quick standard rate turn.
You got it. I always, again, like to demonstrate the wigwag. You've got plenty of aileron control still in this thing, right at lowest maneuverable airspeed right here.
This is a very, very stable airplane. And I like it because it feels heavier.
Yeah.
So there's a lot more control and forgiveness.
Not a lot of people think a heavier airplane's a good thing, but it really, really is because it just gives a lot more locked-on stability. Now, this is a great opportunity. Let's transition this into a power-off stall.
All right.
We're just going to bleed the power back.
All right.
And pitch this up 5 degrees.
All right, right there, 5 degrees.
Right about there. And again, this is the lowest power setting I can get, guys. So it's just going to be at that power setting, unfortunately, due to this altitude. But we got our first indication, which is the horn. We're about to get the buffet.
There it is.
There's the buffet.
Feel it.
And then we're full back on the stick, and this is all she does. That's it.
Wow.
And we'll just keep on staying here for that purpose. Stay in this buffet. We're full back on the stick, guys, and all it's gonna do is just do a falling leaf. There it fell, leaf.
Did
so we're gonna
bit.
Pitch up again. A little bit, keep that 7 degrees. And there's the stall again.
Awesome.
Full back on the stick, and now we'll recover.
There's down the recover.
Power
so
you're gonna
in.
Add some power. A little rudder with it, there we go. Get rid of the horn, give me a positive rate of climb, we'll get the gear up.
Yep, we got positive rate coming in.
There we go. Gear's coming up.
At 500 feet per minute, positive
Gotta
rate.
Love it. With
flaps
the flaps
coming
in,
up.
Flaps coming up. It might be tough to see on the camera, but we were full aft on the stick. Could you pull back any more
I
on the stick?
I couldn't, no, I was going back as far as I could.
Yeah, so full aft on the stick, and all she does is that nice little falling leaf. It's pretty amazing. Even up here at altitude. And it warned us a bunch of times.
It
said,
did.
Hey, stall warning horns on. Here's a little bit of a buffet, but you still can fly it a little bit.
That's right.
And then there's the stall. All right, guys. Well, you know, going flying would be nothing without some sort of mission. So the unofficial mission today was I wanted to go check out Pike's Peak.
Oh,
so
yeah.
We're about to do an orbit around Pike's Peak at 12,500 feet.
Oh, there it is.
Beautiful. Here's actually a great example of a scenario where we're above the clouds. We know that the clouds are VFR conditions at Centennial. You can't do this in many other airplanes. Because this plane's liquid cooled, we have the ability to kind of drop it through a hole as needed to stay under VFR conditions. So I'm gonna demonstrate really quickly here. I'm gonna descend down pretty rapidly. I'm gonna pull the power back to idle. I'm gonna bring the gear out. There's a hole through here that's plenty wide, a couple thousand feet wide. And we're just going to descend this down in the green and pick this little hole to kind of come through in order to be safe and legal on the other side.
Yep, we're coming down about 2,500 feet a minute.
So you cannot do this in any other air-cooled engine because all you're going to do is shock cool the motor. We got the power back at the idle position. It feels like it's giving us some resistance against it. Now we're descended down through these clouds and we can now see Centennial. And we did that 100% VFR without a single problem. So that is one of the takeaways of this airplane that's quite incredible. Along with the other Diamonds, you can do that with the 4262 and the 40NG.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because of the liquid cooled aspect. And check out this coolant temp. It stayed rock solid within the green. You're not going to hurt anything.
That's
now that
point.
We're underneath all the cloud deck, I'm just going to add some power, bring the gear up, And we're just going to cruise our way, continue in to Centennial, and I'll start calling them up in a little bit as we get closer.
2150 Romeo Golf Centennial Tower, verify Tango, make straight in 35 right, report a 5 mile final.
We have Tango, we'll make straight in 35 right, we'll report 5 mile, 150 Romeo Golf.
The cool thing about the new NXI Phase 3 is we can plug in visual approaches. What this is going to do is this is going to load up a glide path for me so that even far out before I can see the Pappy or Vazzy or what have you, it's already got the glide path already programmed in for me, so it's quite nice.
Wow, and that's something that even as a private student you can learn to utilize.
100%.
Not having the full grasp of what an ILS or a GPS approach is, just using that visual as a glide path. Care if I take the landing?
Please do.
Yep. Straight out, connect tower 23.
So guys, for your knowledge, we did vectors the final on the visual approach. I even armed the autopilot, so the flight director is going to follow that. That's our 5 mile ring. Whenever that comes on the runway, we'll report it effectively. Usually we're short final around 90, and then we're flaring around 80, and then she'll sit down, as you can see, the stall speed to the lower 60s. If you want to bring it in tight, you certainly can.
Yep.
But we've got plenty of room on 35 right.
Tower 150 Romeo Golf, 5 mile final.
Experimental zero Romeo Golf, traffic 11 o'clock, 4 miles left base, pair the runway Cessna, runway 35 right, clear to land, 10306.
Clear to land behind the base traffic, 150 Romeo Golf.
So the first notch of flaps, you can't hear it, but in a minute, we're going to put the Fowler flaps in, the last notch of flaps, and you'll start to hear the whistle effectively. Nicely done, 100 knots indicated. When we get over this lake, I'll give you the last notch of flaps. What you'll see over the front is a great, great visibility. 3, 2, 1, your Fowler flaps are coming in. Add a bit more power. I keep saying the Fowler flaps are coming in, but your last notch of flaps are coming in. These are Fowler flaps.
That's gonna slow us way down.
Way down, and check out that sight picture. It just, you know, puts that tail so high that you can just see everything quite well. And you're just gonna go down, aim for the numbers, try and stay as center-lined as possible. We're on the glide path, 2 white, 2 red, looking awesome, and we're clear to land.
Perfect. We've made the runway, so walking that power out.
You got it. Keep on nosing her down, bring that power back. And power at idle. Keep on working down, keep on working down, a little more down, a little more down. All right, now start to get nose high. There we go, there's stall. There she sits. Nicely done.
There we go.
Perfect. Nice work, Patrick.
Thank you. We are on our West USA tour right now, so check the link in the bio to find a stop near you in your city, and make sure if you like this video to like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell, share it with a friend, anything to support the channel, we appreciate it. But until next time, we'll see you guys.
Thanks, guys. See you.